found it to be very, very exciting, because I think the way you began, you know, with so many examples and so many illustrations, I think it really brought out the essence of what we actually have to understand. And yes, you did finish well within time, but I think we could have went on listening to you. With this, I open the floor to our lovely audience for a lot of questions. And before I proceed further, I would like to compliment you, sir, on the fact that how beautifully you have executed and how seamlessly you have executed the session. You can ask the questions either via unmuting yourself and, you know, participating in the in a one-on-one conversation, or you can also post it on the chat box.
Good evening. Good evening, all of you. Good evening, sir. Good evening, Namrita.
Good evening.
Yeah, this is a nice session, nice start to the new session. And yes, as you rightly said, we would have gone on and on listening to what sir was saying. Very, very informative, and yes, can be implemented at many areas of work. I'm representing Kotak Education Foundation here. This is a CSR of Kotak Mahindra Bank, and we are working with the underprivileged schools. And I can specifically question about, I would like to get some answer about the SWOT analysis and the emotional status. So as I said that we are working with the CSR, and it means that we are working with the low cost schools. The emotional status of these teachers currently is really very low, very low. And no need to make a SWOT analysis. By heart, we know everything. The weaknesses are more in the current scenario, and the strengths have gone down, though they are immensely strengthful teachers. So my question here is, or rather I'll put it in that way, I would like to get an answer of, there are not many emotions where we can take care of, you know. There are sometimes, and in this difficult scenario, many a times there is a breakdown of the teachers here. How do we handle the most difficult situations here of the emotions?
Right.
The next session.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So thank you very much. So it was a good question. So we are finding the same situation. So if you take in Sri Lanka, the teachers get paid the least salary for a graduate, what did they get? So that means obviously they are also emotionally very in a pathetic situation. So what we can do in such situation is give them, there are two things you can inspire people. So one thing is building their like life happier. Second thing is giving them opportunities to build up. So what we do is we use the second method, because we know that most of the schools and most of the areas, they are not financially strong, give such facilities for a teacher. So what we do is we bring them up, we give them opportunities. For an example, in Sri Lanka, we start one called Most Innovative Teacher Award. What we do is we cooperate with organization and the organization who wants to do such like contribution, and we collect them. And what we do is teachers who are doing good work, what changing the lives of students, we take them out, we pull them out, we appreciate them, as well as we make sure that they will get recognized in the international level also. So that's one thing you can do, because you are just giving them a hope. If you do good things, if you be passionate about it, the things going to change. So that's what we are going to do, is we find the like opportunities as much as possible. So there are some plenty of organizations around the world. So if you want more details on it, I am happy to share with you. So that's the best way you can do it. Always focus on the teachers who are working hard, give them a hope, and give them time to build up, so they will work like accordingly. So that's the best thing we can do with them. So that's, I think that answer is
yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. We actually have a few more questions for you, sir. So Miss Madhumita Adhya is asking that in leadership position, how should we behave so that we are not perceived as favoring some teachers? Even we try our best not to be biased. So I think what she means by this is, because being in an administrative position or being in a leadership position, it is very important to be seen as impartial as well, rather than just be impartial. So how can that be worked out, sir?
Right. This is the thing. So when we are teachers, so obviously we can't, as an educational leaders, we can't be so strict, because most of the teachers, actually, if you take most of the teachers, they are so sensitive. So you can't expect to be like crude and control them. It's really impossible.
Mm-hmm.
So best thing is, you can always tell them, you make sure that you are straight away into the points. So best way is, don't hide anything in your heart. Tell them this is the situation. I can help you out. I can help you out doing these things. So that's the best way. Be frank with them. So don't need to like tell them, like, if you don't stick to deadline, what are the things? Always tell what are the, like, let's take you, we are talking about the getting marks on time. So tell them, if you don't give marks, then what will happen? Then we won't be able to send the reports to the home or give the feedback to the student. If you don't give the feedback, then what will happen? Our term work will not be completed on time.
Mm,
so that's
correct.
Act badly on that. So always give them like your honest explanation for them. Yes. No. Sorry.
We.
Yes. Yeah. That's fine. Okay.
Yes. So, thank you, sir.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am. Please continue.
Yes, ma'am. No. I just want to ask one question.
Sure.
Shall I?
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Please.
Okay. This is Miss Anu. I am from Mumbai. I'm working with JBCN International School as an IGCSE coordinator. So, first of all, let me thank you, sir. The points which you brought forward, you won't believe everything, all the pointers which it's connected with me also, because it also came to my mind recently, or I have implemented some of it recently, either with the learners or with the teachers. When you talked about SWOT analysis, recently I have interacted with all my learners individually, and I have done this exercise with them, the SWOT analysis. Okay, so now that you said about SWOT, you just mentioned about the strengths. Okay, so I just want to ask you, what about the other three? Have you ever worked with those parts also, like, you know, because if you identify, or if they themselves identify their weakness in the sense, not just weakness as such, maybe something they want to improve on. If they identify that and if they work on that, don't you think they will be able to overcome their threats in that way, or something like that? In that direction are you giving it? I mean, strength, weakness, opportunities and threats, like that way. What about,
okay,
what is your opinion about this, sir? Yeah.
Your idea is really good, like, but one part is this. So let's assume I figure it out weak. Let's assume I have 10 teachers, I figure it out their weakness. One thing I have experienced is, we should not try to correct all the weaknesses at once. That's the one thing. Most of the teachers are so, they will,
yes,
get it,
yes,
really bad when we get involved at once. So what we do is, we just give them more opportunities. We say that there are opportunity like this. Okay, so for an example, when it comes to, there are some awards. So what we do is, most innovative teacher, best teacher, so those type of things. And always they ask how we can interact with students. So the best thing is, what we do is, let's having a discussion. For an example, I just asked recently for teachers. The best way is, if you want to evaluate yourself, just give them a blank paper, your students, and ask them to write whatever they want and get it collected by yourself, read it by yourself, don't show it to anyone else, not for your section head or anything, just read it by yourself and see what you want to do. Because of that, most of the teachers, they correct their weaknesses, because it's between students and them. So the best thing we can do is make sure that the coordination goes to students and the teacher. And if you want to involve in a critical situation only, you get involved. Otherwise, what you can do is, you can indirectly tell them small steps one. So break their weakness into small steps. Build them one by one. If your teacher gets hot tempered, take only one part where he gets hot tempered. He might be shouting at you, or just raising hand, asking a question. You might only involve there. It's okay. Yeah, you are strict. I know that you are one of the strict. Just fine. But when they ask questions, just be lightly and ask. And daughter and after, then break that weakness into steps and deal with it. That's the best thing.
Great, sir. Yeah, what you said is correct. Instead of considering all, just one at a time, right? Dealing with one at a time. That's what you said. Thank you so much, sir. Yeah, that's a great
idea. Also absolutely agree with you, sir, because even at Brain Wonders, when we do the assessment, you know, whether it's DMIT or the psychometric test or the teaching administration, we have noticed that taking up a very sequential and progressive manner to address each and every aspect of SWOT makes the whole developmental process quite comprehensive and quite realistically applicable also. So I am absolutely on board with that idea as well. And we actually have one more question for you. So Mr. Sai Balan has asked that how do we understand what is on others' mind? I think that is something that every administrator faces at one particular point of time. So yes, we do have assessments and all, but then how can you know, one administrator or a leader or any school head or a educational academic institute head actually understand that, okay, what works for whom?
Okay, that's a real good question. So how can we identify others' mind? So what you do is make sure small observation. For an example, so what I do is, like, when I walk in the corridor, so when I see a teacher like talking to a student outside their lessons, I just observe it. Sometimes the student might be very sad and this teacher motherly look after that question those like students and deal with their issues. And when you see that, and mainly you can find these type of passionate teachers when it comes to extracurricular activities. See how they deal with those students and think why they do it. Always think why they do it, then make some assumption, but don't go for conclusion. For an example, I have seen one teacher talking to students. Always when the students are sad, she goes and asks why you are sad and what are the things. So I just made an assumption. So what are the things? Then what you do is, when you're having a slight discussion, ask about, you have assumption. Now, for an example, I had the assumption. One thing is, she might like children, she might feel the empathy of children, and the second thing is, she might go on through the hardships in life. So at the finally, then you check your conclusion. I found out she lost her mother when she was small. So whenever a child is sad, she's so worrying about it, she goes go to child and she asks from the child why she's behaving like that, why she's finding this situation. So then you identify why that teacher, what that teacher is going through in his mind. So always it's based on your observations. Always each and every second in your time in school, the point of observation, make few assumptions. Take while from her friend or something, just clarify. Don't ask like directly while you're having the friendly chat. Just ask, just try to get whether it's confirmed your assumptions or not. I think if you are a principal, like if school principal, you might have all the details. A sectional head or department head, this question comes about the background, then you can get in an idea what's going on with them.
Correct, sir. I think, you know, using a scientific analysis, if that is not possible, and like unless you do not go for a full full-on personality assessment or something, it's always good to be very, very observant and see how, where that takes you ahead. We have one more question from Mr. VP. How should a leader balance his or her act, ensuring that the ideology of the school is not affected, and at the same time ensuring that the teachers and students' emotional well-being is also taken care of? So how do we strike that balance, sir?
Yeah, so I know that's the best part. Like, I think he might be a school leader of a international school or private school. So usually the owners, most of the owners are like businessmen. They're mainly based on the profit. So they'll be happy if you make more profit. Then the parents will be happy if the school fee is low, if the child get good education. Children will be happy if they get more time to sport and do new things, excitement things. Teachers will be happy if they get paid. So it's, as a school leader, it's really hard to balance all these four categories. So obviously you should understand that there's nothing called exact equilibrium point. There are some equilibrium point which you can make. You can identify. Now, there are certain things which brings which will bring happiness for all these four groups. So always figure it out. For an example, so certain changes you might do in the school. For an example, let's assume you are going to start an activity lab. So some call it, in Sri Lanka, we call it a make a space lab. So what you do is, books are banned. You do activities and practices. Now students are so happy because they do activities, they don't have to make books and anything. But then what will happen when the activity is done? So you let them to take home. So students go home and they do perform the same activity. They might be creating a mortar, they might be creating a windmill at home. Parents are also happy. Then when this happens, then you give the opportunity for a school owner. You can take it as a marketing tool, market your school. Then your school owner will get happy, as well as your teachers will get happy because they are learning something new rather than following the all syllabus and everything. They get doing new thing, and always make sure that opportunity that gives a new opportunity for teachers. So there are points where all four gets happy, all four gets come to one equilibrium point. So that's the best thing. We call that there, even though there are four different areas, there's one point. If you like, it's just like you call them in mass, you call them sets. So there's a one point, there's everyone overlap with each other. You have to always find the things which are in that area, always try to deal with them, always try to trigger those points. So when those points are triggered, even they have some sadness, might be school owner is not happy because he want more profit, but mm-hmm. he will get satisfied to some extent because of this point, these type of points you are going to pull it out. So always find those points in your school.
So I think it's just a matter of using the right tools and strategies to figure out what works for all.
So there's more than one solution for any question. There's more than one solution.
Yes, we just have to keep looking. Yes, sir.